Hi, this is Steve Butts, and this is the video supplement for our review of 99 Nights 2. Now, before I say some of the really harsh stuff I'm about to say, I should let you know that I'm not opposed to the basic concept of the brawler. I've been a big fan of Dynasty Warriors and Kingdom Under Fire, and I didn't completely hate Trevor Chan's Joan of Arc game. But while I enjoyed mindlessly hacking and slashing through the thousands of enemies in those games, this 99 Nights sequel is just plain bad. To begin with, the story is just going through the motions. The basic premise here is that there's this beleaguered kingdom, which is rescued at the point of ultimate catastrophe by a lone, tormented hero. Yes, it's true that that describes the plot of 95% of all fantasy stories, but 99 Nights is remarkably uninspired even by those standards. You're joined by a succession of standard fantasy types, including not one, but two busty elf maidens. The action is told in a series of terrible cutscenes where the poor dialogue is outstripped only by the equally terrible lip-syncing. The whole world might be coming to an end here, but I just don't care. In fact, the only point of legitimate interest here is the sheer marvel that a kingdom with soldiers this ineffectual could bother to endure long enough for you to eventually show up and rescue it. But hey, at least the combat is tedious, right? Now, I have to admit, I was initially attracted by the huge numbers of enemies. Within the first few minutes of the game, I scored a 100-hit combo and thought to myself, yes, I am enjoying my awesome mastery of this game. Then my combo meter climbed to 1,000, and then 2,000, and then kept on climbing. The problem seems to be that most of the enemies are content to stand around waiting to die, and without any real tactical challenge, the gameplay devolves to tedious button mashing. It's true that the visual effects are striking, haha, but even they can't sustain my interest here. Even the varied characters don't offer much in the way of unique fighting styles, which makes having two busty elf maidens boil down to your preference for a certain hair color. Eventually, you'll find yourself just racing past these passive enemies to hit the level triggers and get on with your life. This strategy and the acute shortage of health potions almost seem like the designer's way of admitting that the combat really isn't all that important. The only real danger here is in finding yourself surrounded by enemies and then stepping out to make a sandwich without pausing the game. The boss battles have exactly the opposite problem, but there the challenge has nothing to do with the competence of your enemies and everything to do with their abundant hit points, cheap attacks, and the game's hostile camera. Though you'll die a lot in these boss battles, the only quality that the game is really testing is your tolerance for frustration and disappointment. Now, just in case the story and combat weren't deal-breakers for you, there are plenty of other design problems. Checkpoints are spread out much too far, which means you'll have to replay large sections that weren't even interesting the first time around. If you find yourself overmatched by the cheap tactics and massive hit points of a boss at the end of a level, you'll have to go grind a bit and then re-fight your way through the entire 30-minute level before you can face the boss again. This would be bad enough as it is, but it's especially infuriating once you realize that the experience points you earn grinding away in the game's Colosseum don't actually count. The game also comes with online multiplayer, but I had some trouble finding opponents, and honestly, at this point, who even cares? I was a bit mystified that the game didn't at least provide you with local multiplayer, so you could share your misery with your roommate or live-in nurse. Do not buy this game. Do not rent this game. The title of the game grossly overstates the amount of time you might spend exploring the world. Even calling it 99 minutes would be a bit of a stretch.